Hey everyone, Luke Dog here, and welcome back to Assassin's Creed Brotherhood. Last time, we helped out the courtesans, and now our sister is running the brothel. I'm gonna come over here and quickly get this chest. Some nutmeg. Bet it smells nice. Okay, where to next? Let's do this Christina mission, since we have a certain amount of synchronization. And let's just go over here. Let's go see what's up. Hello guards, don't mind me. And let's just climb over the building. Drop down. Come on. No. Drop. Drop, drop, drop. There you go. Let's see some repressed memories. A reminder that all shop people who see their interests controlled by paper forces must have prior approval to... Let the white light engulf you. Hey, wait up! Wait for me! I'm getting closer! Come on. I can't tackle. This is probably just a loading screen and I don't really have to chase her. Well, here we go.
What about that one?
Oh, she's beautiful.
Okay, then go talk to her.
Just like that? Talk about what?
It doesn't matter. See, little brother, most men are so afraid of beautiful girls that anyone who actually talks to them has an advantage. Just make it up as you go.
What?
What?
Why are you just standing there?
Oh, because I wanted to ask you something, which is, what's your name?
Not one you'll ever need to make yourself.
Aspetta, I wasn't ready. I was planning on being really charming and fun. I just have a second chance. Ah, well.
Ezio, all is not lost. You made her smile. She will remember you now.
No, I can still fix these. I'll follow her a ways. See where she lives.
That's right. We are shortly before the events of Assassin's Creed 2. Follow Christina to seek the renewal of her attentions. Ah, back when Ezio was such a young pup. Florence. Founded by Julius Caesar in 59 BCE, Florentia, as it was called by the Romans, quickly became a center of commerce. After the sacking of Rome in the 5th century, the Ostrogoths took over. Under their rule, the city was constantly under attack from the Byzantines, who sent the population level below 1,000. The Lombards came to power in the 6th century, ending the Byzantine assaults. Florence grew to a population of 80,000 in the 14th century, of which 25,000 were working in the wool industry. In 1378, a major revolt of the lower class led to the wool combers rising up and seizing the government of the city. The progressive, radical democracy lasted for less than 2 months before the upper classes seized control once more, but the revolt so terrified the rich that a century later it was still discussed in hushed tones, much as the 1960s hippie movement is today. The Albizzi family became the de facto rulers after the revolt. Worried about the rise of the Medici family, who were newly rich bankers rapidly gaining influence in Florence, Maso and Rinaldo Albizzi imprisoned Cosimo de' Medici and exiled him in 1433. But Cosimo gained influence behind the scenes and rose to power in 1434, exiling the entire Albizzi family except for Luca, who had become loyal to Cosimo. Luca Albizzi joined the Signoria, the ruling body of Florence, as Gonfalonieri, succeeding Cosimo's old friend Iorio Auditore in 1442. Under the Medici family, which built impressive public buildings and supported such luminaries as Michelangelo, Leonardo, and Botticelli, the Renaissance began with Florence securely at its center. So, Ezio's way of getting a second chance. Whoop! Discreetly follow a girl back to her home. There's nothing creepy about this. No, nothing. Nothing at all. Don't see me. I'm not here. I'm not stalking you. Seriously, Ezio, you gotta get your priorities straight. This is one weird way to woo a lady. In case you guys forgot, Christina Vespucci is that girl that Ezio spent the night with at the beginning of AC2. This is apparently when they first met. Oh boy. Not good, not good, not good, not good. Climb! There we go. Casa di Vespucci. Built by a distant great-great-uncle of the famous Amerigo Vespucci in 1350, the relatively unpresumptuous Vespucci residence is notable for displaying the first painted facade in Florence, a style that was later done to death in the Oltrano district.
I told you I'm not interested.
Si. But I am.
Get in line.
I think not, amore mio. I've decided I'm tired of waiting for you to open your legs on your own. Cane rognoso! What do you want here? This has nothing to do with you!
Nice to see you too, Vieri. I think you're disturbing this young lady's day.
I can't tell. Does Viri have a different voice actor? Or am I just not recognizing the Yuri Lowenthal?
Is that the best you can do?
Shut your mouth! I'll kill you!
Why am I not surprised to find you forcing yourself on a nice girl? Just like your father's bank treats Firenze!
You will pay for interfering. Your whole family will.
I want to say different voice actor, but I'm not sure.
Thank you. That was very kind of you.
Are you all right?
I am now. You asked for my name earlier. It's Cristina.
Piacere, Cristina. I'm Ezio.
Well, Ezio. Looks like you got yourself a second chance.
What a completely convenient happening. And there we go. Now to warp back to Rome. 20 some years later. Wait. 76. Yeah, 20 some years later. There we go. Okay then. Where to next? Oh, we got a courtesan mission over here. I also got a Borgia tower. Which I think I'll do. That way I have this entire top part taken care of. At least as far as towers go. Plus, it allowed me to buy up more of the shops, too. And that's always helpful. To the tower! Where's the captain? Chest! Dang it. Here we go. There he is. Ooh, difficulty 5. Come on. Probably suggest he's gonna flee if he sees me. Of course, I always try and count on that, but just in case. Flag. Let's get the flag.
You will stop, yes?
Got ya! Now everybody flee in terror. Well, that was easier than I thought. Now to just climb the tower. Dang it. Dang it. Blarg. Okay, I gotta go around. Oh, come on. Egg. Ow.
Did you have any luck with him?
Well, this isn't going well. I started out so good. Come on, you can climb that. There. Okay, here we go. Now then. Here we go. No, no. Climb this. There you go. That's a good assassin. Can I climb that? Nope. I can climb this. There we go. And burn it down. Geronimo! That's another one down. Ooh, there's a bank. Let's go get the bank. Excuse me. Excuse me. Banco. I saw you, pitpocket. Let's withdraw my money. Taylor over here. San Giovanni di Fiorentini. Once completed, San Giovanni became the National Church of Florence in Rome. Pope Leo X initiated an architectural competition in 1508 for a new church to be built in place of the old St. Pantaleo. The winning architect went by the name of Sansovino, but there were complications and construction slowly ground to a halt. Many different people tried to finish the church over two centuries, and it was finally completed in 1734. There's something to be said for the efficiency of a dictatorship, although the death toll accompanying one is a little unsettling. How much does this cost? 800? Sure, I'll take it. I could always use a good tailor. Speaking of which, among Renaissance merchants, tailors belonged to the new middle class and were paid well for clothing the rich in the latest fashions. Many were able to get close to their wealthy clients due to the intimacy of their job and create lasting ties.
Come, let my experience guide.
Pouches. Ooh, unlock smoke bombs. I don't have those yet, apparently. Huh.
Of course, I understand.
Let's see, where to now? Oh, there's a courtesan mission right over here. Let's do that. Might as well. And then we'll start making our way toward one of the other missions. Our first deed for the courtesans. Excuse me. Hello.
Ezio, I entertained Bavarese ambassadors last night. They must have poisoned me. How? We drank from the same cup. I don't remember what happened next. Come, we must find them.
Are you sure we're poisoned, or you just didn't have a lot to drink? Complete the mission in under 400 seconds. Well, if you say so. Wait. Okay, it just says, okay. Am I supposed to punch them out? The enemy are right there. It's him, isn't it?
He was there.
What are you pointing at, Kutan?
Wait, was it him? He looks familiar. But no matter. Come, I will find another.
Okay, let's make sure it's the right person this time. I don't want to accidentally have to beat up a bunch of people just because you can't remember who poisoned you. If you were poisoned. What? Oh, there's someone in front of me. Where to now? Scusi. It's him, isn't it?
You poisoned me!
Die, merda!
I remember his name. Gizmo. Or is it your follower?
I apologize if you can hear the vacuum upstairs. This way now?
Grazie, Ezio. I am sure at least two of them were there last night.
Buona fortuna. And stay out of the wine, Madonna.
You're pretty sure two of them. So why beat up someone that we didn't have to? One in Rome. Okay. Let's see, there's a mission down there, there's a mission over there. Let's head this way. Hey, revenue. Excuse me. Hello, ladies. Excuse me. Pantheon. Oh yeah, your hotel. Huh. Cool. Sorry.
What's with him? Ezio, since Madonna Solari's death, her brother Santino claims ownership of us. He struggles to gain Borgia favor and must prove himself leader of the courtesans. Humiliate him in public, and he loses the support of the Borgia. We will not hear from him again.
Stop Santino before he beats up the courtesan. Beat him up, but do not kill him. Got it. Excuse me. Fist of Fury. First, I'll take your money, and now I'll take you. I know. I'll put you right in front of the Pantheon, for all to see.
This man is a worthless liar. The courtesans of Roma will never answer to him.
And I bet only two people listen to him. Did you go into the Pantheon, Tom?
Yes.
What do you think?
Was pushed back more. Other than that,
nice Oculus.
Yep.
Okay, where to now? Borgia Tower. Slowly making my way to another mission. Chest? No. Flag. Okay, where's the captain? What difficulty was this? What are you doing here? Ow. Santi Apostoli. This early Roman Catholic building was built by Pope Pelagius I to celebrate Narses' victory over the Ostrogoths. Like many other structures, it suffered severe damage from the great earthquake of 1348. It was restored in 1417 by Pope Martin V, and later again by Pope Clement XI. Gotcha. Now we just climb the tower. No, I'm gonna run. Bye bye. And I'm climbing the wrong building. There. You're gonna be annoying. Bye bye. Okay, that's it. Stupid archers. Too late. Let's try this again. Here we go. Climb on up. And burn it down. And there's a bank right here. Now, can I have my money? Thank you. Let's head to this one. Looks like we're starting to go out into the more of the countryside. Captain. Difficulty 3.
Join your face,
Borgia!
picking a fight with the boss. You must have a death wish showing your face in a borgia, Rione. Picking a fight with the borgia was not smart. You bet you please. You must have bet you please. Picking a fight with the borgia.
Yeah. Will you just die already?
Give him a gun.
He's quite talkative.
Yeah, I noticed.
You must have a death wish showing your face in a board cameo. Beg you, please. You must.
Yeah, the hidden pistol.
Showing your face in a bit. You must have a death wish showing your face in a board cameo. Beg you, please.
Oh, damn.
You must have a death wish showing your face in a board cameo. Beg you, please.
Will you just die already? Thank you.
It's about time.
Now to burn your tower. I'm not a peasant. Really, Ezio. Burn down. Poof. What's wrong, Clover? Okay, we've gone about. Lots of stuff nearby to buy. I'm gonna try to go to this, but if it's blocked off, then that means it's part of the mission. So I can't remember exactly which end is the thief and which one is the fighter. We'll see once I get closer to it. Colli Quirinale. Situated northeast of the city center, Quirinale is one of the seven hills of Rome. Tombs from the 8th and 7th century BCE have been found here, confirming theories of its existence as a Sabine settlement before being assimilated by Rome. Constantine I had his lavish private baths built here as well, although all that remains are a few drawings. Huh, nice to know. Yep, I think this is part of the mission. So in that case, we're gonna go over here. Caserma del Viano. Used by Bartolomeo until 1503, his barracks became a training ground for mercenaries until they fell into disrepair and were leveled to make way for the enlarging city. The spot was marked by a memorial in 1960, but no one was quite sure where the barracks were actually located, so the idea was scrapped in favor of a park, which was in turn scrapped in favor of a fast food restaurant. Huh. And they're changing the smoke detectors.
Ezio Auditore!
Hey!
Come in! I'll kill you if you don't.
Bartolomeo.
Wait here. You have to meet my wife. Fantasilea! Fantasilea! Where is she?
Did you check behind the table?
Ah, here she is.
Lieta di conoscervi.
Charmed. Truly.
Now, we talk about war.
How was the fight against the French?
Bene. My men are holding their own.
Machiavelli seemed to think things were more difficult.
You know Machiavelli...
Abbiamo bisogno del vostro aiuto!
Scusatemi. Throw me Bianca.
Ezio, let me get straight to the point. The fight is not going well. We've been attacked on both sides. Borgia on one, French on the other. But know this. The Borgia position is weak. If you can defeat them, we can concentrate our forces on the French front.
I think I know a way to help. Thank you for disclosing this to me, Madonna Dalviano.
It is the least a wife can do to help her husband.
Kill only the Borgia captain. Okay.
Someone stop their leader before he gets to the tower!
Patetilea Baglioni, born in 1476. Wife. Although she may look harmless, Patetilea comes from a long line of fierce fighters. The Baglioni, rulers of Perugia, had been at war with the Odi family for some time, and skirmishes in the squares of the city became an almost daily occurrence. At one point, the cathedral was used as a barracks. In 1500, during the marriage of Astori Baglioni, the Odi attacked, killing the groom and several others. The Baglioni counterattacked, and several of the Odi were murdered. The marriage party became a massacre. Patetilea was a product of that rough environment. She was smart, unafraid, and tough. And, unlike her husband, she had tact. Patetilea was known for sharp strategizing. Whenever that girl encounters resistance, like the waters of the Tiveri, she changes course until she has that for which she came. Now she has you. May you both be better for it, wrote Doge Agostino Babargo after learning of Bartolomeo and Patetilea's marriage in 1498. Hey, Agostino! We met him in the last game. Anyway... Bartolomeo Dalviano, born in 1455, Condottiero. Born in the town of Alviano in central Italy, Bartolomeo grew up to be a clever and resourceful soldier. After spending several years in Venice, during which he aided Ezio Auditore in his campaign against Silvio Baborgo and Dante Moro at the arsenal, Bartolomeo joined the Orsini family in 1496 to fight against the Pope and Cesare, who were attempting to seize Orsini territory. A few years before Cesare had him killed, the Pope's eldest son, Juan Borgia, the Duke of Gandia, waged an inept campaign against them. At one point during the siege of Bracciano, Bartolomeo sent an ass out of the gates with a sign around its neck reading, "Let me go, for I am an ambassador to the Duke of Gandia." The letter roped to its tail contained further insults. After his victory at Bracciano, Bartolomeo moved to Rome and remarried. Yes, Patetilea Baglioni was not Bartolomeo's first wife. Oddly enough, he originally paired up with his nominal doppelganger, Bartolomeo Orsini, who died during the Borgia assault in 1497. He married Patetilea the same year and immediately became entangled in a battle with the French faction of Cesare's army, led by the Baron de Valois. Just goes to show that wives may come and go, but battles are forever. At the end of 1503, Bartolomeo left Rome after being hired by Ferdinand II of Spain to help the Spanish army defeat the French and seize the Kingdom of Naples. The following year, he defeated Maximilian I, the Holy Roman Emperor, taking Trieste and Gorizia. Impressed, Venice elected him to the office of Governor General. Everything was coming up roses for Bartolomeo until the disastrous Battle of Agnadello in 1509, when he disobeyed orders to avoid combat and directly attacked the French army. The battle was lost. Bartolomeo was captured and wounded by the French, and the Venetians lost Lombardy, a province it had taken them 800 years' exertion to conquer. Further, Venice refused to help Bartolomeo despite his claim that the French commander had stolen a priceless Venetian artifact which he was attempting to rescue. Bartolomeo was kept in French prison until 1513, but the French, as we all know, are very forgiving. He was sprung from jail to fight for them, managing to defeat the Swiss with only 300 men in 1515. Later the same year, once restored to his former glory as general of the Venetian army, he was killed besieging Brescia. Venice welcomed his body home with a grand ceremony and buried him in the church of Santo Stefano. Now, getting back to the matter of hand.
Someone stop him!
Colle Viminali. The smallest of the seven hills of Rome, Viminali, is shaped like a little finger pointing toward the central city. At the top stands the Palace of Viminali, which is the office of the Ministry of Interior. This little hill was also home to the Terme di Diocleziano, which were renowned as the grandest of the public baths. There we go. Now I loot you. And now we climb the tower. Sploosh. Maybe I should have taken the road. Oh, never mind. I got a flag here. Here we go. Climbing up, climbing up, climbing up, up, up. Come on. I hear twinkling. Oh, there's a flag right there. Gotcha. Now to burn it down. To get out of here. Going up. Ooh. Leg. Running, running, running. I got to run around this little lake. More tomatoes. Here we go. Thank you. Probably would have been easier if I called my horse. Come here, you. Scusi. Little bit quicker.
Hey, hey! Ezio, we sent those lurid codardi running for the hills.
Yes, we did.
Now that the Pope's dogs have fled, I will be able to draw more men to the fight. But first I want to reinforce our barracks.
Who will take care of this?
I'm no good with these things. You are the educated one. You approve the plans.
Va bene. But in return, I need to know Cesare and Rodrigo's every move. Can your men keep track of them for me?
Of course. Isn't she a thing of beauty?
Very impressive.
More men join us every day. It has become very competitive, which is just the way I like it. As you can see, this board shows the ranks of our top warriors. Prove your skills, and you will move up the list.
Shouldn't I already be at the top?
Jan's fighting downstairs!
If you're looking to show off, we also have fights. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got money on this match.
Where is Bartolomeo?
At the fight downstairs.
He has such an aggressive view of the world. However, strategy is equally important. Take these carrier pigeons, for example. Each one sent from Machiavelli bears the name of an important Templar in Roma. Eliminate them, and you will have more of an impact than a battle ever could.
Thank you, Madonna. Can you ask Bartolomeo to come see me at Isola Tiberina with a report about Cesare and Rodrigo's whereabouts?
He will be there.
Okay, and with that, I'm gonna end the video here. If you liked this video, let me know in the comments. If you really liked it, press that cute little like button. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'm Luke Dog, and I'll see you next time.